Afghanistan's future looks uncertain as U.S. troops prepare to leave the country before September 11, 2021. In the years after the U.S.-led military invasion and the defeat of the Taliban government in late 2001, the Afghan government and international donors gave priority to developing an effective health system, including extending access to basic health care to all parts of the country. This led to significant improvements for women's health. But even with two decades of effort and hundreds of millions of dollars spent, delivery of health services for women and girls remains far below international standards.
Our maternal mortality rate nowadays is 638 per 100,000 live births. It is a shocking number.
In the last several years, donor support to Afghanistan has been falling. Services that were already inadequate are further deteriorating. Women and girls often struggle to access even the most basic care, access to contraception, access to prenatal care, access to safe birthing services. The cost for transportation, as well as medications, and the supplies patients are obliged to pay for because government hospitals no longer have enough funding, keeps women from receiving care, with sometimes deadly consequences. Insecurity and fighting due to the war in Afghanistan also create major barriers to women and girls accessing health care. Health facilities and workers are often caught in the middle of the conflict or even targeted themselves, making it almost impossible at times to provide services. In May 2020, attackers killed 24 people, including mothers, children, and a midwife, in a hospital maternity ward operated by MSF in Kabul.
With the conflict and uncertainty about the outcome of the peace process, donors are more hesitant about committing funding to NGOs or to Afghan governments. In the midst of uncertainty, it's the most vulnerable, it's the women, the children, the displaced communities, they are losing out.
Over 75% of the Afghan government's budget comes from international donors. Afghanistan cannot afford decent health services without help. Donor countries should fully appreciate how deep and urgent are Afghanistan's humanitarian needs, including for women's health care. They should not use the withdrawal of foreign troops as a justification for disengaging when the need for international assistance is greater than ever.